What is Nuremberg Code of Ethical Guidelines for Research? We will focus on the history of this code and the elements associated to it. To begin with, it was all around the World War II where human beings were used as subjects for medical trials. And at the same time, there were questions raised about the criticism of the impact that was done on the humanity, the critical way of approaching the humanity and the injury to human life without their voluntary consent. And this was one of the major reasons that the Nuremberg Code came into existence. So this is a German, this derives itself from a German word which is Nuremberg Codex. And codex, and this focuses on the trials which was as a result of the experiment done between US versus the Brand case. Any unnecessary pain or suffering to an individual must be avoided. So what happened was, this was called as the doctor's trial. There were 23 physicians, so there were 20 doctors, and it was believed 3 of them were administrators. So these 23 people who were from the German Nazi party were tried against the crime for the crime against humanity. So what happened when the World War ended in 1945, all the Allied powers who got victory basically started this trial, and this trial took place mainly against the German Nazi party, the physicians from the German Nazi party. The claim was that these doctors and administrators were basically using people who were part of the Auschwitz concentration camp for their studies, and the way in which these humans were used were actually dehumanizing, and numerous Jewish prisoners were part of this project. So what happened was, there was a case which was the United States of America versus Karl Brandt case, and this was known as the doctor's trial. So the official document of this trial was named as the USA versus Karl Brandt case, and under this, this case was conducted in a building in Nuremberg in the region of Bavaria in Germany, and this was only one of the largest unclaimed buildings, undamaged buildings which remained after the World War II and after the intensive bombing which was done during the World War II. So as we said, this was also symbolic because this was the place, Nuremberg was the place which was the birthplace of the Nazi party, and therefore this was symbolically chosen as one of the centers. Now there were 4 counts that were taken into account. What were those 4 counts? The first was the common design or the conspiracy. The second count which was taken against them was the war crime. The third was crime against humanity. And the last was the membership in any criminal organization, if so ever. Clear? So these were the 4 counts which were taken into account. And based on that, the code of 1946 was laid down. It said that voluntary consent of an individual is essential. So when you are taking any subject for experimentation, you have to take a voluntary consent of the patient, of the subject. The results of the experiments should be for the good of the society. Before human beings, it should be done on animals first. There should be no physical or mental suffering which should be given to an individual. No experiment would be conducted if it is believed that it can lead to death or disability. The risk should never be more than benefits. So always benefits should be more than risk. Adequate facilities should be given. Experiments to be done only by qualified scientists. Subjects should be able to end their participation and should be allowed to move out of the study at any point of their time. And scientists in charge must be prepared to terminate the experiment if any injury, disability or death occurs in the experiment. So those are some of the 10 codes which have been given under Nuremberg's Code 1946. Now this was the foundation for the GCP, which is the good clinical practice, which is an attribute of excellence in research talking about better design implementation and analysis, and also the well-prepared lessons. We have some of the people who laid the foundations of this Nuremberg Code. So Harold Serbing is the one who authored this code, and besides him, there were two major American physician doctors. One was Leo Alexander, and the other was Andrew Lee. Andrew Ivy, both of them had an important role in the Nuremberg Code. So Harold Sebring was the author of it, and this Nuremberg Code is now considered as the basic guidelines throughout the world, even including the Declaration of Helsinki, in the Belmont Report, in the Common Rule. This has been the basis. Before this, in 1931, there were certain guidelines which were given, and these guidelines were much more older, much more briefer than the 1946 guidelines. It did not talk about voluntary consent, but it talked about an innovative therapy that can be carried out only with the legal representation has unambiguously consented to accept the procedure. Okay, also, this should be taken for a person only above 18 years. If the person is below 18 years, there have to be a proper question and a proper care which has to be taken. Also, the report must be made and the justification should be carried out for the same. The points like 9th and 10th point, which are part of it, were not part of the 1931 guidelines. So 1931 guidelines were very, very small as compared to the 1946 Nuremberg Code, and this Berlin guideline basically were laid down by the Prussian government during that time, and this was just an embarrassment about why there have to be ethical standards which have to be taken into light. But with the Nuremberg Code, this became the standard procedure for most of the drug trials that take place across the globe now. So this was the basis foundation. Now we understand why the history of this Nuremberg Code, where how the Nazi government, the Nazi German party, the doctors from the party were part of it, and it was seen that there were cases that were lodged against the doctors for dehumanizing practices which affected the life of the people. So there has to be a voluntary consent which has to be taken. Experiment should not lead to any physical, mental suffering or injury, death or disability of an individual, and these must be prior carried out to animals before being carried out to humans. Those are some of the major things that we take out from the Nuremberg Code. Very important in light of the COVID vaccination that we have seen, how the phase 3 trials were released, and therefore this code becomes a very important topic for your examination point of view. We would be covering many such contemporary topics in the upcoming session. So stay tuned. Wish you good luck.